Hi there, Mike here. Welcome to my guide on running Plex Media Server and Jellyfin Server on Bazaar using Quadlets. While you can run both Plex and Jellyfin on DistroBox, there's a much simpler way. Before we get started though, I've created a companion blog post for this guide, which we'll be using for copying and pasting the config files. You can find the blog at mikestechtips.medium.com. And here's the blog post. I will put a link in the description below. In brief, what is a quadlet? A quadlet is a podman feature that allows you to easily run containers as systemd services, and it uses a straightforward syntax, much like a Docker Compose file. That might sound like a lot of technical jargon, but it's much simpler than it sounds. Let's make our first quadlet. A Plex Media Server quadlet. Open your file manager. If you aren't showing hidden files and folders, press Ctrl-H to show them. Now select your home folder and enter the .config folder. Now let's make a new folder called containers. And inside of that new folder, we will make a new folder called systemd. Now inside of that systemd folder, let's make a new text file called plex.container. Open it in Kate, and we'll be copying the contents of the container from my blog post. Now you may want to change the path of your videos folder. I'm making the assumption that your username is Bazite and that your videos are stored in your videos folder on your home folder. Once you've changed the path to work with your environment, save the file and open the terminal. We'll run the following command to refresh the available systemd services. systemctl --user daemon reload. Now you can start the service by running the following: systemctl --user start plex. The first startup will take a while for you, since it needs to download the Docker image for Plex Media Server. I've done this process before on this machine, so the installation is almost instant. Now that the service has started, navigate to localhost 32400/web and set up Plex like you normally would. Note that when you're adding your libraries, your videos will be in the /videos folder, since that is where we are mapping the actual videos path to in the container. If you restart the machine, your Plex service will auto-start, and the reason for this is this install section in the container file. This wanted by Xorg desktop auto-start will start up the service as the desktop starts up. What if you need to add another path to the server? It's simple. We just add another volume to our Plex container file. Now we save the file, go back to our terminal, and we will do daemon reload, and then just restart the Plex service. Unfortunately, that path doesn't exist on my test machine, so I'm going to comment out that volume and redo that. How do we uninstall our quadlet? You start by stopping the service. systemctl --user stop plex. Then we'd want to remove the two internal volumes that we made in our config file, plex config and plex transcode. So we run podman volume rm plex config and plex transcode. And there we go, we fully uninstalled. Some people may prefer an open source media server, so we'll be doing the exact same thing with Jellyfin. Navigate to your config containers systemd folder that we created above, make a new file and call it jellyfin.container. We're going to go back to the blog post and we're going to just grab my config file for Jellyfin. And obviously you might want to change your path as we did before and save the file. Go back to the terminal. We run system control daemon reload. And then to start our Jellyfin server, we just run systemctl user start Jellyfin. Your first startup might take a minute or two. Now let's navigate to our Jellyfin server. Localhost 1896. And set up the Jellyfin server. Add a library, home videos, add the folder, here's our slash videos folder that we added in our config file. Next, next, next. And there we are, all set up. Note that if you want to add additional folders, you can do it in exactly the same way as we did with Plex, but preferably with a folder path that exists. How do we uninstall our Jellyfin quadlet? It's very similar to our Plex one. We stop the service and we remove the related internal volumes. Systemctl user stop Jellyfin. Podman volume rm. And there we go, we fully uninstalled. And now for the conclusion. While DistroBox is a great option for running additional software on Bazite, Quadlets provides a superior and more streamlined solution for applications that need to run as a service, such as Plex and Jellyfin. If you'd like to dive deeper into Quadlets and explore more examples, including how to run a Minecraft or Samba server, have a look at the Quadlet section in the Bazite documentation, which I've linked at the bottom of the blog, and I'll put a link in the video below. Thank you for watching. Please subscribe and like if you enjoyed this video and want to see more videos like this. Have a lovely day. Goodbye.